I wonder what your guys' take on it, but when fans started booing yesterday, do you think fans should be booing five games into the season, or does it not make sense for them to do that? Because I have my opinion on it, but I want to see what you guys think.
I personally don't like booing at all. Like, even if I'm a Mets fan, like, I'm never going to boo a Mets player. That's my ideology. And it's going to suck. Like, I'm trying to think of someone. Like, let's say Jose Altuve comes to the Mets somehow. I'd be really mad, but yeah. I'm still not going to boo him. Like, I'd be really, really, really mad. I would never buy a Jose Altuve t-shirt.
That's a good point.
But I just can't see myself being like, oh, screw you, Mets. Because, like, I've been here for at least 20 years. So it's like, you know, we've been to the ups and downs. I got to keep running it out. Can't give up now.
I mean, I'm frustrated that he's not coming through, but I'm not saying, you know, boo Conforto. But I do, like I said, you do want to move him around because it's clear it's mental. Like, we know Michael's a good player, and it's all just in his head right now. Like we said, the contract and everything like that. So just move him around and see if you could make something better happen. But to have him bat third every single day and deal with that pressure, you know, I thought it was a good move, and we didn't get to see, you know, the benefit of it because, of course, the game got rained out. So, I mean, and that was another thing, too. You know, the other day they're talking about all the Mets. They got lucky finally. They got hit in the elbow. Right back to unlucky today. So, I mean, it came back around real quick.
It was both ways.
Yeah, it evened. It's probably going to be more unlucky than lucky by the time the year is over. So, that whole storyline evened out real fast.
What I was going to say about the booing is that
I would never boo. Like, I'm not the person to boo. But I don't know if I completely understood people saying it's five games into the season, you can't boo yet. The way that I looked at it is the fact that the Mets have had so many opportunities, especially to me, it made a lot of sense in the Jacob DeGrom game. He's pitching outstanding, and it's a constant pattern that the Mets can't do anything with Jacob DeGrom. I would be so frustrated if I was at that game. You're seeing, like, a magician pitch with Jacob DeGrom, and then Michael Conforto comes up, strikes out with runners in scoring position, and just the Mets in general can't do anything with runners in scoring position. And it's just so frustrating. I personally would never boo.
Would you boo Rojas?
Rojas, I am mad at, but I don't think I would boo him either.
Okay. Because he's not playing, so maybe you get him instead.
Yeah. Basically, what I'm trying to say is, like,
I think some players, you can motivate them. Some guys, it can really get in their head. So yeah. It definitely depends on the particular player.